Sometime in 1996, a foreign correspondent called up journalist B.N. Unyal to ask him if he knew any Dalit journalist. After spending days talking to friends and colleagues, Mr. Unyal was unable to find anyone. Like zero, literally. In 2017, after having conducted a similar search across the country for more than 10 years, journalist Sudipto Mandal said he was only able to find 8 Dalit journalists in English media, and only 2 of them risked coming out to him. Between October 2018 and March 2019, News Laundry and Oxfam together conducted a research project to find out more about the representation of marginalized caste groups in Indian media. The results were shocking to say the least. 3 out of every 4 anchors in flagship debates on TV news were upper caste. Not one Dalit or Adivasi or OBC. Only 10 out of the 972 articles featured on the cover pages of the 12 magazines that we looked at were about caste-related issues. And no more than 5% of all articles in English newspapers were written by Dalits or Adivasis. The research suggests that Indian media is still dominated by upper castes. Scheduled tribes are almost entirely absent, while scheduled castes are represented mostly by social activists and politicians, not by journalists. OBCs are similarly underrepresented, even though they are estimated to constitute over half of India's population. The fact that me, a Savarna, is sitting here telling you all this in a video is testimony to the findings of this report. The report is basically aimed at opening and informing a public debate on discrimination and social exclusion in media. Let's go back to the basics first. Caste is an ancient system of discriminatory segregation that is determined by birth. It is based on notions of purity and pollution and is rooted in the Hindu doctrine. The caste system divides Hindus into 4 varnas or categories. These are Brahmin, Kshatriya, Vaishya, and Shudra. Those who fall outside these endogamous groups, each with a preordained social function, are known as Dalits or scheduled castes and Adivasis or scheduled tribes. The still pervasive caste system, unsurprisingly, rears its ugly head in our newsrooms too. There are vast sections of India's marginalized caste groups who lack access to media platforms and discourses that shape public opinion. This leads to certain voices not being represented in our news ecosystem. Take, for instance, leadership positions in newsrooms. Of the 121 newsrooms that the report looked at, a whopping 106 were occupied by journalists from upper castes and none by those belonging to scheduled castes or scheduled tribes. Let's take a peek at the panelists on English TV news channels. A mere 5.6% of panelists across the survey channels belong to scheduled castes. And shockingly, not even 1% of them belong to scheduled tribes. What's even more bizarre is that during the discussions on caste issues, 62% of the panelists across news channels were from the general category. 89% of leadership positions in English TV news channels belong to the general category, along with the 76% of anchors who hosted flagship shows. The results got even more skewed when we looked at Hindi news channels, where 100% of the leadership positions belong to the general category, and so did 80% of the anchors on primetime shows. Let's take a look at newspapers. According to the report, media professionals from marginalized caste groups do not occupy any leadership positions in the 6 English newspapers and 7 Hindi newspapers that we looked at. In the 16,000 articles that we pored over in English newspapers, over 60% of the articles were written by upper caste writers. In Hindi newspapers, nearly 56% of writers belong to the general category. The only silver lining was Amar Ujala, where 100% of the articles published on caste issues were written by contributors belonging to the marginalized caste groups. Now let's look at digital media. 84% of all leadership positions belong to the general category. Just like newspapers and TV news channels, there is no representation from scheduled tribes and scheduled castes in the digital media space. In fact, the study found that 56% of writers belong to the general category. And yes, News Laundry was also one of the organizations that was surveyed. Now coming to magazines. The study chose 12 magazines covering a range of interests. Among them, 63.5% of the total output came from the writers belonging to general category and only 11.2% from scheduled castes and scheduled tribes combined. while OBC writers contributed to a meager 1.1%. Talking about giving space to caste issues, only India Today, India Today Hindi, The Caravan and Sarita gave space to caste issues on their covers. However, a majority of the caste stories published in these magazines were penned by general category writers. At India Today Hindi, this percentage stood at an overwhelming 99.5%. The report clearly signifies the dire need for the inclusion of marginalized groups in Indian newsrooms. For an equitable and developed society, the representation of all is a must. And more than anywhere else, this applies to our newsrooms.